Let's read Genesis 13.
Genesis 13, verse 8.
And Abraham said unto Lot,
let
there be no strife, I pray thee, between me and thee, and between my herdsmen and thy herdsmen, for we are brethren. Is it not the whole land before thee? Separate thyself, I pray thee, from me. If thou wilt take the left hand, then I will go to the right. Or if thou take the right hand, then I will go to the left.
Amen.
Can you see the verse there?
Verse 9.
And Lot lifted up his eyes and beheld all the plain of the Jordan, that it was well watered everywhere before Jehovah destroyed Sodom and Gomorrah, like the garden of Jehovah, like the land of Egypt, as thou goest unto Zoar. So Lord chose him all the plain of the Jordan, and Lord journeyed east, and they separated themselves, the one from the other. And then Abraham dwelt in the land of Canaan. You can see the verse there. Verse 14, and Jehovah said unto Abraham, after that Lot was separated from him, lift up now thine eyes and look from the place where thou art, northward and southward, eastward and westward. For all the land which thou seest to thee will I give it to thy seed forever. Can you see that verse there? Let's Amen. Pray. Thank you, Lord, for your word. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
I was reading this verse today,
and
I found that God always uses separation. Can you just write, God uses separation? If you can read, you will see the separation between Lot and Abraham. And then the way they separated, you could see that the character that Abraham was showing. I love Abraham because he's the father of our faith. Because the Bible says he never looked at the place because of the condition of the place. From the beginning, when Genesis 12 introduced Abraham moving out by God's command, is when God spoke and said, Abraham, get out from your people. It was separation. And is then I'll bless you. This teaches me that unless we have some separations, there will be no change in our lives. But that separation must be coming from God. God uses separation because you can see God here speaking with Abraham and say, Abraham, after they separated, God spoke for the second time. Listen to this. In the first time, he said, get out from your family. Since then, Abraham was moving, but God was not speaking. The reason why God was not speaking, Lot was there. But when they are on the road now, and they start to be having everything, that's where problem starts. And when the fight begins, Abraham might have believed God and said, now I understand what God has spoken. God wanted me to separate with my family. Now look, now I brought this one. Now we are fighting. So let's separate. Can you just take any place? I'll go the opposite side. That's what Abraham brought to Lot. He might have remembered what God has spoken. It's God who separated him with his family. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
So you can see there, when God speaks, he said, now Abraham, Listen, this is the land you can look at. After that separation, God brought a promise. After separation, there will be a promise. Now, God
says,
Abraham, this is the promise I'm giving you. Can you see this land? I'll give it to your generation. Listen to this. There are times when you are with people, God won't talk. God wants you to go away from them.
He'll speak.
And if this happened, what God will speak is a promise. What God wants to do is to give you a promise. He doesn't want to give you a result. He wants to give you a promise so that you have hope unto him. What God demands from you is you hoping unto him, trusting him. Here God wanted to show that he is a God that Abraham must trust. He is not separating him with people and leave him as he is or as he was. He was there to bring what he said he will bring. I don't know if you are hearing me. Today, as you are here, as you are hearing me, God will separate you with your family, but he will bless you for the sake of your family. If we read about Joseph, it happened the same, where God separated him. And the brothers were against him, but he never understand what was happening. Whereas God was bringing solution. Hallelujah.
Praise
the
Lord.
The solution of the future. I don't know what you are facing today, but just understand that separation is to bring the results of the future. If we read 2 Corinthians 6 from 14 to 18, you will see God speaking. He says, separate yourself from them and I will receive you. I say 2 Corinthians 6:14-18. Separate yourself from them and I will receive you. Listen to this. There are some people you need to go away from them. And if they don't believe what you believe, they are there to delay what you believe. That what you believe will delay to come. But I believe today, God will guide you. Who are those people? Separate yourself from them. Come out from them. And then separate. And I will receive you. If you read 1 Kings 11, from verse 1 to 6, we see a king that was chosen by God. The Bible says Solomon was chosen. There was nothing that he can cry about, because in his time there was no enemy that can rise up and fight him. But there was a law that God gave to Israelites, that they must never mix up with other nations. But Solomon never followed them. The Bible says he never followed that. He began to marry wives from Moabites, Amorites. Many ladies. And the Bible says when he grew up, they affected him not to follow God fully. They affected him not to follow God fully. Can I tell you this? There are many people today are affected by people not to follow God fully. When God says separate, so that when you pray,
you pray to the fullness, you worship to the best. Otherwise, these people will be the stumbling blocks. What God wants you to do is to go away from them or to build a wall where you cannot see them again. Because as long as they are there, they will dilute you. There are some friends, there are some people in the family, there are some people around us in the church where we are staying. We have got nothing to do with them but to love them. What the Bible says, he said, separate but don't make them enemies. I don't know if you're hearing that. You separate with them but you don't make them enemies. We need to be Christians that if we have got some plans, we don't say them to everybody, because you can be surprised. Such people can affect fully the plan of God upon your life. Even you following God fully can be affected. I see some people here that from today they will receive the fullness of God upon their lives. I don't know if you are hearing me. Listen, you must reach a level whereby there is nobody in your life that can affect your Christianity in a different way, in a negative way. You must reach that level where when you do fasting, no one stops you. When you are obeying God, no one blocks you. I don't know if you are hearing me. Otherwise, such people are there to stop you so that you must not receive what God wants you to receive. You must separate with them. I don't know if you are hearing me. That's what my friend, there are some people you are living with. You must leave them from today. Can you tell somebody, there are some people you are living with, you must leave them from today. Can I tell you this? God will never bless you when there are wrong people around you who don't believe in what you believe. Otherwise, they will kill you or work against you. I pray that God separate you today with the wrong people, with those who are fighting you, with those who are competing you, so that your focus will be a heart of seeking Him. We must reach a level where when we come to God, we seek Him only. We don't pray against someone, but we separate. Even when God wants to punish, if you read number 16, He says, Moses, get away from them. Get away from them. Listen, if you won't separate, you will be punished with them. I don't know if you're hearing me. That's why, my friend, if you're not separating with them, you will be punished with them. I want to prophesy someone who's praying for the blessing upon his life. I say, God is giving you wisdom. I said, God is giving wisdom. Those who are against you, you must leave them behind. Those who are blocking you, you must overtake them. They must never stop you. If you believe, say amen. God wants you to separate with them. He will never bless you if they are there. Including the issue of prayer. There are some people, when you pray with them, it won't work for you. I don't know if you are hearing that. Okay, let's look at this verse. In 2 Thessalonians 3, let's read from 13 to 15. 2 Thessalonians 3, from 13 to 15. Tell somebody, my friend, if you are not following God, you are not my friend. Can you read in your Bible, mama?
Arivaleng. Erego mmile na bana be sho. Lesikela lapa go dira tshe bulo. Ge go ka ba lese liye a salira teo. A sarate o kwa lengwalo le le bolelago. Lese sorry. Le lese go kopana nae gore a hlajwe ke dihlong. E sebe.
You are reading what, mama?
Verse round 9 now, I was reading 14.
14. Read 14 again.
Ge go ka be le a sarate go gokwa se lengwalo le le se bolelao le le se go kopana nae.
Just read that verse in your Bible there. It say what?
Bala mo Bible ya lena, in your own Bible.
In verse 40, it says
14.
And if any man obeyeth not our word by this epistle, note that man. He said, note that man. That he have no company with him. To the end that he may be ashamed.
So that 15.
And yet count him not as an enemy, but admonish him as a brother. I was learning that many times. We compromise a lot. I've been doing that too. We love to compromise because we don't want to hurt. We want to forgive. But here the Bible says, let's bring shame to that one by not accompany with the person. But we must never say the person is the enemy. Look at that verse. It says, especially verse 14. It says what? If any man obey not our word or this epistle, note that man. In other words, you need to be wise to know people around you. You need to be wise to know people around you. Tell everybody. You need to be wise to know people around you. Listen, most of the time, it's like we are afraid we end up generalizing. What God wants you to do is to find people that will dilute you. And you separate them from them. So that they will see and repent. And be saved again. I don't know if you're hearing me. What God wants, He wants people to win other people in the right way. I want to win in the right way. If you separate with them, don't kill them. Don't show them their mistakes that they are bad. But do it to win them. That's what the Bible says. Here, that's where we see the writer of Thessalonians encourages separation. If we read Proverbs 24, verse 1, he said, be not thou envious against evil men, neither desire to be with them. Do not be envious against evil men, but don't desire to be with them. We need to check how we relate with people, our friendship with them. If people are evil, they are not your friends, and don't fight them. I don't know if you're hearing that. It says, let me read it again. Proverbs 24, verse 1. Be now thou envious against evil men. Because many evil are rich. Many evil people have got everything. Don't desire them. You can rather make friends with Christians who fear God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Because that's the reason that God wants to do this year. Because there's going to be a wealth transfer. If you desire them, and you stand with them, you can still lose what they are having. And it will be taken to Christians. I see Christians taking over. I don't know if you're hearing me. Listen, you can dominate by separation. You can move forward by separation. You can reach your destiny by your separation. As long as you are separating with people from people that devil can use to stop you. I don't know if you are hearing me. If you read Matthew 4, verse 12 to 17, the Bible talks about Jesus when he heard that John the Baptist was killed. He never went there. The Bible says he went to the desert. He didn't want to make a noise. He didn't want to raise a commotion. He separated himself aside so that it must not disturb his assignment. The Bible says the moment he heard that John the Baptist was killed by Herod, what he did was he took the disciples and he went away. Later, he was in Capernaum. He began to do miracles there. I don't know if you are hearing me. This is the time that we need to separate ourselves with things that doesn't need us. If something happened, if it is the will of God for you to be involved, just be involved. But if it can affect your destiny, don't be part of that. We need Christians who cannot just indulge themselves in things that they don't need them. Let me prophesy someone. I believe there will be no situation that will affect your assignment this year. Whatever that is created around you to stop what God has created you for, this year will be cancelled. Can you tell somebody, say, my friend, I won't entertain anything that will affect my destiny. Jesus, he spoke about John the Baptist and said he was more than a prophet. But when he was killed, he never spoke about it. He said, I'm leaving it to God. I've got an assignment. I've got a ministry to run. I must run my ministry and I must run my race. We need Christians who cannot be affected on their race. Can you tell somebody, say, my friend, your problem, I will be involved in it if God wants me to be involved. But if it blocks my assignment, I will separate myself. There are some Christians who are hearing me right now. I hear that God is giving you assignment and nobody will block it. If you believe, shout hallelujah. Go and read Mark 5, verse 40. The Bible talks about the person that was dead, and when Jesus reached there, he said, this child is not dead. And the people who were there began to laugh at Jesus. And Jesus said, it's better I take all of them out. He took all of them out. And he took only the parents. I said, you parents, believe on what I'm saying. These people can be a stumbling block to what I believe in. He took all of them out. And the Bible says there was a miracle. Can I tell you this? There are some people you need to take all of them out to see a miracle. They are there to affect your miracle and to stop your miracle so that it must not come to your life. I don't know if you are hearing me. Check somebody, say, my friend, there are some people you must leave them. There are some organizations that you must run away from there so that you see the plan of God upon your life. The Bible says he took all of them. All were laughing. All were contrary to his faith. This is the time when you want to see results. Whoever does not believe in your results is the enemy of your results. hearts. Take them aside. Separate. You don't need to listen to them because they will discourage you. I see some people who have been discouraged by other people. I'm here to encourage you. God wants to do a miracle. God wants to bless you today. Whatever they are saying, it won't happen this year. I'm saying it will happen in your life. Separate with them. They will come by the day of celebration. I see them coming to celebrate with you. I see them coming to rejoice because of the result that God wants to do in your life. They don't need to know how you are achieving things. Separate with them. They will come back. They will come back being surprised. They will witness God doing wonders in your life. There are some prayers we don't need to offer. We need to bring separation. There are some marriages which are not marriages. They don't need prayers. They just need separation. There are some friends which are not friends. They don't need fasting and prayer. You just need to separate. There are some people in the family that the devil is using to block your miracle. Hey, you don't need fasting prayer. Separate away from them. Stand your ground. Even when you are alone, you are majority with Christ. You don't need majority to encourage you on the plan of the living God. You alone, you with Jehovah, you with Jesus, you are majority. I say you are majority. You have got people, always when you meet, you talk about the things of the world. Those are the people of the world. We need Christians who talk about what God can do from the word of God. We need people who can tell you about the verse they are believing for their miracle, where the power is coming from. It must come from the word they believe. We need Christians. Christians, really Christians, who can separate from the wicked. The Bible said the wicked are like chaff. They can be carried by the winds. You are rooted. We don't need people who will be carried by the wind. They can end up affecting your focus because you are rooted there. I see you being rooted there. You will bear fruits on the right time. I see fruits that are coming. I prophesy fruits that are coming in your life. You are rooted. You are planted. Just remove something. Separate yourself with the wrong things. Separate yourself with the wrong friends. If they don't believe in what you believe, they are there as a stumbling block. They are there to block you. I'm hearing someone here. Today, that God is exposing his enemies who don't believe what he believes. Those who are pretending to be like they are standing with you, they are about to be exposed because God wants to do a new thing in your life. I see a new thing. I see a new beginning. I see God raising you in front of them. I remember what David says. He prepared the table in front of my enemies. They will see the table that has been prepared, but they won't partake on that table. They must be far away, but they must see God providing. If you believe, shout hallelujah. I know some people have left you because some people have left you. There are some people who look at some people. When they leave you, they also leave you. And God has allowed it for that separation. I see that separation is working wonders upon your life. I see you as a Christian. And I see you standing grounds of reaching reaching your destiny. If you believe, shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Shake somebody and say, hey, separate away from me. I know where I'm going. If you leave me, I don't mind. My God has not forsaken me. He will never leave me or forsake me. He is with me until today. You can go away, but I will stand my ground. Where I'm standing is where God wants me to stand. I prophesy someone who's facing turmoil and challenges. I say, hey, your time has come. Where those who loved you, they will begin to see your God working. If you believe, shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
If you believe, shout
hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Listen to me. I see some people who are here today that the family has rejected. There was separation. I see a divorce that has happened. Hey, it is the time to rejoice, because whatever you are facing, it is the plan of the living God upon your life. This is the time of rising up and shout your shout, because you know God is about to do a new thing. If you believe, shout
hallelujah.
I see some people who are here. You are facing rejection, but I'm here to tell you, you are the one who will be celebrated. That separation was working for the good. That separation was working for the good. I see this separation is working for you. God uses separation. God uses separation. Even Jesus, the Bible says, when the time of his crucifixion has come, when he went forward to pray in Gethsemane, he knew that he must separate himself. When he kneeled here, when they kneeled, he stood up and kneeled ahead. When he kneeled ahead, those ones who were left there, they began to sleep. Can I tell you this? If you know your assignment, God will never allow you to sleep now. You will never sleep now. I see you praying, and there will be a result of your prayer. I said there will be a result of your prayer. When Jesus separated with them, when he's busy praying, when he came back, he found they are asleep. All of them were the same. My friend, if you want to do the different things that other people are doing, just get out from them and separate for a while. And see, when you come back, you will find them that they don't understand what you are facing. They don't understand the challenges you are going through. And hear and shout to you that God is about to put you in your assignment. And in that assignment, get out from them. Get out from them. Get out from them. Get out from them. Separate. You know they are wrong. You know they are not living right. Get out from there. You know they are there to stop you. The devil is using them. Get out from there. I see someone here who's getting out, and God began to bless that particular person. The problem you've been facing for many years is about to be solved in a minute, because God knows your action, and your action starts from your heart. I see you getting out, and everything will work for you. If you believe, shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
If you believe, shout
hallelujah.
Say, I'm getting out. I'm separating myself from my God.
I'm sacrificing myself
for my God. By setting myself aside, by putting myself aside, can I prophesy someone? Can I tell you this? God wants to do big things. things. He was waiting for you to move out from them. Move out from them and have different prayers. Move out from them. They must not know your secret. I prophesy you that what you are about to receive in your whole generation, no one has ever received. I see you driving a car that nobody has ever drove. I see you staying in a house that nobody has ever stayed. I see a life you are living. It's about to be an example. It's about to be an example. Shake somebody and say, this year, I am an example. I'm here as an example. Even if you leave me, I will prosper in front of you. Even if you leave me, God will provide a way. God will provide a way. I see a way right now. I see a way here. I see a way. Separate yourself. Separate yourself. I say separate. In the name of Jesus. I say separate. I see the anointing that is coming upon your life to take you aside, to make you a different person. I say separate. I say separate. For your God. There's a special anointing that is coming because you are separating yourself. You are becoming different. I prophesy you. I say this year, when they look at you, they will admire you. And when they admire you, they will copy you. And when they copy you, they will ask the formula. It's Jesus. I see separation. It's very good. I see separation. It's very good. I see rejection. It was good. I prophesy that this year you will shame the devil. You are clapping the devil. If you believe, shout hallelujah. There is separation. Sit down.
To love us.
If you want to see that God is up to something, allow people to fight. When you fight, when they fight you, keep your mouth shut. Carry on with your life. Your life with Jesus matters in front of your enemies. Separate yourself. I see someone here. Some people are still holding your history and your geography. But I'm seeing you that the day is tall. I said the day is tall. The day is tall. They are holding your history, but you are moving forward. They are talking about your past, but you are going somewhere. Shake somebody and say, hey, stop wasting your time. Move forward. Congratulations.